So when you went to work this morning, or when you went to work yesterday, or when you go to work tomorrow morning, same story every single day, you're wondering why it is that you're not progressing faster, more successfully than some of the other people. Don't worry about it. We've got the answer right here. Not my answer. It's Dr. Diane Hamilton, author of Cracking the Curiosity Code. Why people don't progress as rapidly as they should? Are they holding themselves back for the same reason?
Well, they're holding themselves back for several reasons, and I found four reasons, but the one we're going to talk about today is they make assumptions that may be tied into their past experience that have not been maybe correct what they've assumed. And that's what we're going to talk about today. I'm going to do a little couple things to show you how your assumptions might not be what they should
please,
be.
Please, I may be assuming too much already.
You might be. What I want to start with is a simple puzzle. I mean, this is a tetrahedron. I don't know if you can zoom in on that, but this is a puzzle that they brought to MIT professors, and they asked them, how quickly can you put this puzzle together?
I've already flunked. I can't spell tetrahedron.
Tetrahedron, say that three times real fast. Okay, so you have to put this together. It's a two-piece puzzle. Pretty simple, right? You want to try it?
No, I am just so bad.
But okay. This, see, what you're doing is what most people do. They try to, I don't know if you could zoom in on what he's doing there, but it's basically very challenging for people because they're basing their... Can't take it.
Okay.
It's too much for some people. Actually, one guy just gave up and walked away.
Yeah, oh, I think there I may
go.
Do that.
There you go. Well, see, the problem is you probably haven't put a... puzzle together that's this shape before, so you've made assumptions of how puzzles should go together. Most people will put it together like you did. They put it.
Yes.
And really what you do, just to give you the trick, is you do it like that. And
oh, sure, but see, you have,
I have
already
prior
cracked
knowledge.
The curiosity
I
code.
Have
you know
practiced.
How to do that.
I do. You want to try it again? Yeah. Wait, no, you're getting
no, no, no. I don't want to see. No, I want to see how you did it. Oh, okay.
Okay, the trick is, so you know,
all right.
You put the two squares together.
Right.
Okay, usually they'll go like this, and then you twist it.
Okay, the executives that are in charge of my career rarely ask me to do this.
Well, they might now, since
okay,
they saw you can't.
But what have I solved if I
what
know how to do that?
What you've solved is you've thought in a different way. And what we want people to do is to think differently than they've thought in the past. Because right now, we want employees who are innovative.
Give me another example.
Well, another example of thinking of what's not really what we thought it was is a watch. If you have, don't look at your watches if you have
one. You're
going
to ask me to put a no. clock together.
Yes, can you put this together from scratch? No. What we're going to do is if you have seen Roman numerals on a clock,
mm-hmm.
You know what a Roman numeral is usually? An I and for one,
Super
two
Bowl.
Eyes. Right. So what would be the number for four? Would it be, I've got a couple examples. Would it be this
IV.
One or this one?
IV.
Well, that's what you would think, right?
Yeah.
Well, if you look at a clock, is the glare on that? I hope you can see that. The four is actually four eyes. And people assume, because they know what Roman numerals should be, that everything is going to be that way. They don't really know why they made the watches this way. There's a lot of reasons that for balance, maybe because
yes.
of seven. But the point is, if you look at everything and think, well, does it always have to be that way? Is there another way of looking at it? Am I making assumptions that aren't
at
correct?
This moment, Diane, I am assuming that the people in the control room are going to come out and attack me because we've run out of time. But
aww.
The rest of the answers are in the book.
Right.
Cracking the Curiosity Code. Look for the name, Dr. Diane Hamilton.